ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Loosely Woven concert. It's wonderful to see so many wonderful beaming faces, and we hope you're going to enjoy the concert. Before we start, we would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge and pay our respects to the original inhabitants of this wonderful area that we are privileged to live in. It's the Teramagagal people from the Guringai Nation. They've handed this lovely land to us to look after and to pass on to future generations. So please relax and enjoy the show.
Well, I took a stroll on the old long walk with the DIA. I met a little girl, we stopped to talk on a fine soft day. I
and I asked you, friend, hey, how do you do? Put your hair black and eyes blue. And I knew back then I'd take it alone. From the top of your gun with a bowling gun.
We were halfway there when the rain came down with the day. Ticket home.
We sometimes even go out of Sydney. We've gone up to Grafton and Tamworth and Yamba, and we've gone south. We've gone down to Canberra and Goulburn and Penrose and Millthorpe and Lure and Bathurst, all sorts of places. Even a couple of years ago, we went over to New Zealand and did a series of concerts over in New Zealand. We do this just for the fun of it, never for money. We never accept payment at all, not even for expenses. We just do it because we love doing it. And that's a public concert, and I'll tell you a bit more about that later on, because we're about to start tomorrow night, the first performance of our new public concert for the end of the year, but I'll tell you about that later. Those of us who are available during the weekday do things like this. Since I've retired, people who are retired as well or have got flexible jobs, one day a month we go into retirement villages and do a concert in the morning, We did this concert this morning at Southern Cross down the road. And then this afternoon we're doing it here for you. So one day a month we do that. The two, one in the morning, one in the afternoon. We don't accept payment money, but we do happily accept food. So thank you very much for the sandwiches. So we've been doing that. And so the program that you're here this afternoon is one we put together at the beginning of this year, made up of songs from last year's public concerts. Right? We took out the best of last year's public concerts. What we were able to do, because it's not always the same people in the group each time, but what we were able to do with this group of people, we put together this program, and we've been performing it all year, one day a month, two times. So this, as I said, we've done it, this will be the... it's our 11th month and 22nd performance, and our final one, so we decided it'd be nice. A lot of the stuff that's in this concert was in our public concerts. We do have it already videoed and have it on YouTube, but it is slightly different people doing things in this concert. And also, there are two or three songs in this concert that we didn't do publicly last year that only you guys have seen, so we thought it'd be nice to have a record of that too. So I do apologise for all the stuffing around. I especially apologise for, I think I've broken your vase over there, but we'll sort that out later. Anyway, on with it. So this, as I said, all these numbers came from these people. It was Noni, our harpist, who said, why don't we do that last song? Did anyone know that, recognise that last one? Any Irish people here? Because that's an Irish song called Galway Girl. Anyway, this one... There will be songs you know, and there'll be ones that you don't. This is probably one of the ones that you don't know. And I don't know about you, but I kind of like being introduced to new things. And so this will be one, unless there's any Chinese people. Any Chinese people in the audience? No. If you were, you would probably almost certainly know this, because it's very popular in China, isn't it, Lily?
Yes.
Anyway, Lily is going to sing.
Yeah, this is a love song, but it's a sad love song. Hope you like it.
is one that
Frank.
Yeah, Frank brought to the concert, and as usual, Frank usually lowers the tone of the concert.
I try to.
Somewhat.
This song that we're going to sing for you is Come a Little Bit Closer. It was a hit for Jay Black and the Americans. Do you know of Jay Black and the Americans?
Yeah.
Right. Anyway, it's this, the song is set in a little cafe just over the Rio Grande, the border of America and Mexico. And in this cafe is this gorgeous little señorita. And she sits there most of the day smoking a black cheroot cigar and sipping tequila. And she's in love with Jose. Jose's a paunch little Mexican guy with six guns. And while he's out, he's the bad guy. While he's out looting and doing whatever he does, she eyes off the young, handsome, debonair guys that come in. So here, I'm going to play that part, and I'm going to sing you this story. That's what it's about. So if you know the tune, sing it. If you don't know it, what do you do? You hum. So please, hum along with me.
1, 2, 3, 4.
In a little cafe on the other side of the border, oh, she was just sitting there giving me looks that made my mouth water. So I started walking her way. She belonged to Batman Jose, and I knew, yes, I knew I should leave when I heard her say, so inviting. Oh, and I just couldn't resist just one little kiss. How exciting. Then I heard the guitar player say, Famous Jose's on his way. And I knew, yes, I knew I should run when I heard her say, come a little bit closer, you're my kind of man. Say, man, you know you're in trouble plenty. So I dropped the drink from my hand and through the window I ran. And as I rode away, I could hear her say to Jose, come a little bit closer, you're my kind of man. So big and so strong, come a little bit closer.
Every Easter we go down to Canberra and spend the weekend there at the National Folk Festival. Anyone been to the National Folk Festival? Any folkies? Fabulous, isn't it? And last year when we went, one of the acts that we really enjoyed was a group called Co-Chol, funny name, but they're a group of three women from Melbourne. And and they sang beautiful harmonies. One of them played the harp, one of them played the flute, and it was just gorgeous stuff. And this song we're going to do for you now is one of the ones we heard them do, and we've sort of copied their arrangement as best as we can. So it's beautiful. Yeah.
Cool.
Thank you. Yes. It requires a different hat. This is called Green Grow the Rushes. It's not quite the one you think it's going to be.
Women.
There's naught but care on every hand, in every hour that passes on, that signifies the life of man, and were it for the lassie, oh,
rain grow the rushes, oh, rain grow the rushes.
Oh,
Well, what the name of the song was in, you probably don't know, End of the Line. But who was it that performed it? Oh, come on, this morning they knew.
Come on, yeah,
Traveling Wilburys.
Well, well. The big quiz is, who are the Traveling Wilburys? Who are the people in that group?
George Harrison.
Yes. George Harrison. Well done. And who? Tom Petty, and the other two big names. Roy Orbison, remember Roy Orbison? This poor bloke got forgotten this morning too. These very wealthy men, who obviously didn't need to come up with a bright idea to make more money, they just did it for the fun of it. I bet it was George Harrison's idea. They just decided, hey, why don't we put out a record under some other name? And the CD itself just had Traveling Wilburys on it. It had no mention of George Harrison or Bob Dylan or Roy Orbison. Everyone knew, of course. And that was the single from it, so great fun. Now, I don't know what normally people come here to perform for you. What sort of songs people do when they come and you have it? Because I'm sure you have lots of entertainment here. But yeah, I think maybe you'll get some other not so usual things in our concert, but this is one I'm sure you've had before.
Yeah, we'll definitely know this one.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Follow every byway.
because they're written by people in the group. Every now and again when we have our planning meeting for one of these concerts and we go around the circle, people suggesting things that they'd like to do, every now and again we have someone in the group who says, I've written a song that I would like to do. It doesn't happen as often as I'd like, but every now and again it does. So we've got two songs now, both of them, only the words written by people in the group. In this case, this was a poem of Noema's from way back, and she asked one of the members of Lucy Woven, she's not here today, asked Katie whether she would set it to music and turn it into a song. And Katie did, and now Noema's going to sing what was her poem and now her song.
Yes, it was a poem. It was about indecision, really, whether to stay in Australia or whether to go back to the land of earthquakes, not bushfires, where we have chili bins, not Eskies, and we have jandals instead of thongs. Anyway, this is my little song that I wrote. So.
One, two, three, four.
I'm going for a coffee in old Sydney town. Maybe Auckland, if I'm feeling really down. Don't really feel like I can be all of that. So hey, 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 pass me my hat, 'cause I'm out of here and I'm all alone. See you later, pass me my hat.
Australia is the land of bushfires and droughts, we all know that. But I've listened to the firefighters all over the world over the last few years, and they all say that the fires are intensifying, the season's getting longer and longer. We're getting fires in part of the world that we never had before, up in the Arctic. But if you listen to ScoMo and others, everything's okay, steady as she goes, no problem whatsoever. Somebody is lying. Jason Felici got up on Monday night at Q&A. He told a pack of lies, but he gets away with it. I make reference in verse 4 to Dr. James Hansen. He's the NASA scientist who rang the bell 40 years ago and predicted exactly what's happening now. The predictions he makes for the future are truly, truly horrendous.
Come gather round, people, wherever you roam.
politicians and lend me your ears. Put the planet ahead of seductive careers. Pick up your pens, cause catastrophe nears. And this world that we love is worth saving. And God's looking down with his eyes full of tears. For the climate, it is a change.
Original song, but it is a song, one of the most powerful songs that I've ever had the pleasure to sing, and written by one of Australia's finest singer-songwriters, and I hope someone here has heard of it. His name is Archie Roach. Oh,
yeah.
Ah, look at that, always heading like that. Well, the rest of you have now heard of Archie Roach too. If you get a chance to go and see him perform, grab it, because there won't be too many more of those. He's not a well man, unfortunately. But we'll have this lovely treasury of wonderful songs that he's written. In our brand new concert that we're starting performances tomorrow, we've got an Archie Roach song as well. In fact, we're opening with it, I think, aren't we?
Mm.
But this is another one of his that we did. Look, I hope none of the women here have personally experienced what the topic of this song, what this song is about. I really do hope. But I think we've all, no doubt, heard about this, read about it, seen it in movies, seen it in TV shows and things. You know, when a woman arrives at church or arrives at work, arrives at the club, and she's got bruises and a black eye, and people say, "Blimey, what happened to you?" And she sort of somewhat hesitantly sort of says, "Oh, I walked into a door." Mm-hmm. And we know damn well that's not what happened at all. So this is Archie Roach's song to his fellow men to get real about this very, very serious, serious topic. It's called Walking Into Doors. 'cause I'm a man. I don't understand, but I try. She always does what I command while she cries. And why should we do what we do and sleep at night? The crazy things we put her through, it isn't right. So my we're doing in our opening, our next concert with her. She's a darn sight cheerier, that one, I promise. In fact, let's cheer yourself up right now with a blues. It's funny, isn't it? A lot of blues songs are actually really very lively. This is one. San Francisco Bay Blues. One, two, three, two. being in it.
So I have contacts.
Because he looks like a pirate, I suppose.
Okay, I play Mabel, and this is Frederick, the ex-pirate. And he comes along and spies me and my sisters putting our foot into the, about to put our foot into the water at the beach.
Skinny dipping they were.
And he says, stop, ladies, pray, because he's there. And then he asks, is there not one maiden here that will be his love? And all my sisters say, no way, Jose. Well, actually, they say, not one. But I say, yes, one, I will.
Lucky me.
One, two, three, one.
Oh, wandering one, song, sing rickety tickety tin, about a maid I'll sing a song who didn't have her family long. Not only did she do them wrong, she did every one of them in. She did every one of them in. One morning in a fit of pique,
sing rickety tickety tin.
One morning in a fit of pique, she drowned her father in the creek. The water tasted bad for a week, and we had to make do with gin, with gin. We had to make do with gin. My mother, she could never stand,
sing rickety tickety tin.
My mother, she could never stand, and so a cyanide soup she planned. Her mother died with a spoon in her hand, and her face in a hideous grin. A grin, her face in a hideous grin. She set her sister's hair on fire,
sing rickety tickety tin.
She set her sister's hair on fire, and as the smoke and flames grew higher, she danced around the funeral pyre, playing her violin,
She weighted her brothers down with stones, sing rickety tickety tin. She weighted her brothers down with stones and sent them after Davy Jones. And all they ever found were some bones and occasional pieces of skin.
Oh!
Of skin. Occasional pieces of skin.
One day when she had nothing to do,
sing rickety tickety tin.
One day when she had nothing to do, she cut a baby brother in two.
Oh.
And served him up as an Irish stew. And invited the neighbours in. Invited the neighbours in. And then at last the police came by,
sing rickety tickety tin.
And when at last the police came by, her little prank she did not deny. To do so she would have had to lie, and lie she knew was a sin, and lie she knew was a sin.
My tragic tale I won't prolong,
sing rickety tickety tin.
My tragic tale I won't prolong, and if you do not enjoy this song, you've yourselves to blame if it's too long. You should never have let us begin. Begin.
You should never have let us begin.
Please tell me there's someone who can tell me who wrote that. Well done. Lehrer, you've heard of Tom Lehrer. He was a wonderful, he was actually a mathematician in America in the 50s and 60s, and he started writing songs like that one and lots of very, very funny songs. But that's sort of just a bit of fun, that one, and just taking the mickey out of the Irish, but a lot of the other ones sort of had quite serious intent to them, and it was interesting. He like a lot of us, if you cast your mind back to to the 60s, it was an amazing time, wasn't it? We really thought that the world had changed, that whole business of make love, not the war, behind all that, there was actually quite a serious feeling that things have changed, and that we're not going to have things like the World War II again and Hitler, and that people will know better how to treat each other and look after each other. But of course, as time went on, I don't know whether the world's ever been in a worse situation, and certainly the inequality, the gap between those who've got few people that have got all the money and great masses of people that are just starving and struggling, and it's very disillusioned. And he got so disillusioned with what he saw was happening that he stopped writing and stopped performing, and he went back to just being a mathematician. He's still alive; he's in his 90s now, but he just sort of. It was just awful for him. Anyway, we have a wonderful legacy of Tom Lehrer's songs, and that's one. This is, I have to tell you something, that My wife and I, the violinist in the blue dress, 12 years ago, the Lambie Heights Uniting Church was up for sale, and we bought it. So we now live in what used to be the Lambie Heights Uniting Church, or at least that's our lounge room. In the hall, we've put a second story of their bedroom bathroom, but the old church, which we call Humph Hall, we need the poo in case you're wondering where that came from, the name, is a home, is our lounge room. And I'm sure you've driven past it many times, going up Lambie Road before you get to the shops, and then down from the Spastic Centre. Cerebral palsy line, sorry. That's where Loosely Woven rehearses. We rehearse in Humph Hall, and we do performances of our concerts. We'll be doing two performances of our new show there in December. But we only do the three concerts a year, so the rest of the time, Gal and I, we invite other people to come and do concerts in our lounge room in Humph Hall. And for over 10 years now, we've been doing this, and amazing people from all over the world, all over Australia and all over the world, come and perform in our lounge room. Some fabulous stuff. Strongly urge that you think about coming to one of some of these concerts. Our concerts are always free. When we have professional musicians, particularly international artists, we do ask you to make a donation. But only if you can afford it. And if you really can't afford it, then that's fine. You know, if you can't afford the 25, we ask them to pay 20 or 15 or whatever. I wouldn't want anyone not to come to a concert because they can't afford it, if you really can't. You'll love them. We do not use a PA system. So if you're really so hard of hearing that you can't hear without that, then I don't suppose you should come, or at least come and sit down the front. But it's the beautiful acoustics and wonderful people. And one of those wonderful people had performed was a Scottish singer called Fiona Ross. And she sang this song we're about to do for you now. I reckon it's one of the most well-known Scottish songs. So any guesses? Everyone always says the other really well-known Scottish song. Not this one, but anyway. Can anyone? Well, come on, if I say, what's a really well-known Scottish song?
Banks and Braes.
Banks and Braes. That's not one that people usually bring up, but you're right, that is a beautiful, well-known Scottish one. No, not that one. Any other one? Come on, can you get another one?
That's
the one people usually say. No, that's not the one I'm talking about now.
It's along those lines, yes.
Anyway, you'll hear it, you'll know it. You'll know it even though it's not the tune that you're used to. This is a really well-known Scottish song, but somebody found a beautiful Scottish air and found that it fitted with the words of this one, so they put the words to this new air instead. It's not sort of dissimilar to the tune that you're familiar with, and you should be able to sing along later on. We all start singing if you want to. But this is absolutely beautiful. It's also very miserable. It's one of the saddest songs, I think.
Enjoy.
Three, four.
For his king and Prince Charlie.
Afternoon, everybody. This next song that we would like to do for you, we're doing as a tribute to an American woman singer who's was a very big legend in America, and she was known as the Queen of Soul. So I'm wondering if anyone would hazard a guess as to who I would be talking about. She passed away.
Yes, we've got it over there. It's a smart corner over that way.
That's a smart corner.
Probably all the vitamin E flowing in.
So we'd like to do for it. We'd like to do it for you now.
One, two.
Thank you.
kiss. Or girls, next year I... They really do need the deed to a platinum mine. Santa baby, hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, fill my stocking with a duplex and checks. Sign your X on the line. Santa baby, hurry down the chimney tonight.
Thing, you haven't got to dance. All you've got to do is ding a bell when I point to you, right? Pretty simple stuff. So we need six people to ding bell. Six bell dingers, ding-a-lings. One.
Better be careful, we'll
Felicity. So how this works is this. I'm going to have to sit back here so I'm not the way I'm coming. But when I... we've got serious musicians up here. When I point to you, you've got to be watching. And when I point to you, ding, ding. Ding. No, actually call that a ding, 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 ding. Okay, I'm no longer pointing at you, so stop. Go on. Oi! Oi!
I'm not pointing at you anymore, so you stop. I went back to you and you weren't paying attention.
Right, right. God!
Just watch him all the time.
You like eating yet. We might have to say one.
Here we go. Point to you, did I? What are you dinging for?
I want you, ladies, I want you.
You're very slow at stopping. You're good at starting, but you're slow at stopping. Anyway, we're right. Okay, here we go. You never know. You might even recognise what it is they're playing. Are we ready?
Yes.
You've got to pay attention. You've got to keep watching, keep watching.
Yes.
And because I especially I come back very quickly to you, right? Tom. I'll sit down. Ready? And start with you and jump up to you. Ready? Hang on, sorry. That would be very rude. Thank you.
further away from her, because every time I point to her, you start dinging. We will do it one more. Do you recognise it?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course you did. We'll do it one more time. You can hum and sing along if you like with accompaniment, right? So careful. Don't you ding until I point to you. You don't get much of a ding. It's a long one, though, so you've got to keep going, right? And see what I mean by jumping back to you very quickly there. We're going to have to keep going to this all afternoon until we get it right. You know? I've got some people coming at 7 o'clock. Are we ready? Here we go. Shh.
Things and go. Run.
we might invite him by ourselves. Yen organised these two concerts today, so she knows about you over this way. I've never heard of the bloody Cotswolds, you know. I even spelled it wrong the first time. Catswolds, wasn't it? No, look, we really enjoyed the one this morning too at Southern Cross, it was a lovely one. This is a rather sad occasion for us because a lot of those songs we'll never be doing again. If any of the staff are here you can do that in a second. Yeah, all right. I was going to say, if you want us again next year, contact us again.
One more song.
No, you can. Yeah, we got one more to go, but it's all right. You can treat it like an encore. You can ask us to do one more song.
Yeah. Would you like to do one more for us?
I think we might have.
But before you do, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to say thank you so much to the Loosely Woven Symphony, to the Loosely Woven Choir. It's probably been 20 years since I've heard so many kazoos playing in tune. I can't thank you enough for bringing such joy. Thank you for the generosity of time and effort that you've put into today. Wayne, I really appreciate the fact that you accept no money, that you're one of the few people or one of the few groups that don't. We couldn't let today go by without giving you something else other than lovely sandwiches.
Yeah, they were.
So we've got something for your Christmas party. I'm going to leave it with you.
I bet it's booze. I don't drink.
No, it's not booze. It's not booze. There are some Lions Christmas cakes.
Cake. Yes. Cake, I can have it.
And we would like to invite you back next year for trial by residence at some stage during the year. But before you go, could I ask for one more?
Yeah. Okay, we're going to finish with another Cochiol arrangement. Cochiol was the one that, remember, we got that Green Grow the Rushes we did earlier? And this is that other Scottish song that you didn't pick up before, and we're going to... Auld Lang Syne, but it's again not the tune you're familiar with. It's a different tune, but it's beautiful, and please do join in once we get to the everyone singing bits.